My dear friends, welcome to my channel. In today's session, we will discuss about another example regarding to the dependency preserving. Okay, so here I will consider the relational table with the fields A, B, C, D. Here I will consider the functional dependencies as A, B implies C, C implies D, D implies A. Now, I will decompose this relation into two tables. In the first table, I will consider the fields as A, B, C, and in the second table I will consider the C and D. Okay, so now we will check it whether this decomposition, actually here we will decompose it into two tables, this decomposition is dependency preserving or not. Okay, we will check it. How we will check? So first we will find out the functional dependencies for R1 and R2. Okay, so first we will consider the R1 relational table. So first we will find out all the subsets closures. What are the subsets here? A, B, C, A, B, B, C, C, A. Okay, first we will find out the closure of all these subsets. What is the closure of A? Closure of A derives A. And any dependencies available here? No. Okay, so A derives only A. This is the trivial functional dependency. Okay, so next we will find out the B closure. B derives B. Here no dependencies for the B also. So this is also trivial functional dependency. Now we will consider the C. C derives C. And here please observe that C implies D. So that's why here we will consider the C and D. Here C implies C is the trivial functional dependency, that's why here I will delete C. Here D, actually in this relational table, what are the fields available? A, B, C. Here D is not available, that's why here I will remove D also. Okay, we can't use this. Now we will check it the A, B closure. A, B closure derives A, B, and here one dependency is available, that is C. Okay, here C derives D, so D derives A. A is already available, so we can't consider. Here please observe AB is equal to AB. Actually this is the trivial functional dependency, that's why here I will delete those attributes. And D is not available in this particular table, so that's why here I am deleting D also. Okay, so here what is the functional dependency? AB implies C. Okay, so actually this is a first table, AB implies C. Okay, now please find out the BC closure. BC is equal to BC, and any dependencies are there? C derives D, so please consider D also. And D derives A, so A also. Here BC derives BC means this is the trivial, so we will delete. D is not available here, so I will delete this. Now the functional dependency is BC implies A. Okay, now what are the closure of CA? CA, and here C derives D, so that's why here I will consider D. D derives A, A is already available. Anything? No. So CA derives CA means trivial functional dependency, but here D is not available, that's why here also D cancel, we can't consider this one. Okay, so here what are the functional dependencies are available? AB implies C, BC implies A. Okay, any doubts so far? Okay, so AB implies C and BC implies C in the functional dependency 1. Now we will discuss another functional dependency, that is C2. Okay, so the another relational, that is C, D. Okay, so the subsets of C and D are C, D. C derives C, and C derives D also. D derives A. Okay, so here C means this is the trivial, that's why I will cancel. So here A is available, but A is not available in this particular relational table. That's why here I will remove this. Okay. So in the functional second relational, the functional dependencies are C implies D. Okay. Now please find out the D. D derives A. Okay. So here D is equal to D means trivial functional dependency. D gives A, but A is not available here. Okay, that's why here we can't consider this one. Now what are the functional dependencies available? FD1 derives FD1. AB implies C, BC implies A. Okay, anything missing here? Please observe the C. Here C derives CD. Here please observe one thing, A also. Okay. So C is equal to C, trivial, that's why we will cancel. D is not available here, that's why D also cancel. But C derives A. Okay, this is also functional dependency. Okay, now finally, what is the union of FD1, FD2? Finally, we got AB implies C, BC implies A, C implies A, C implies D. Okay, these are the functional dependencies for first relation and second relation. Now we will check it. All the functional dependencies of main table is available in this or not. First functional dependency, AB implies C. So here also available, no problem. Next, C implies D. C implies D, C implies D is available. No problem. D implies A. So here D implies A is missing. Okay, please observe this. D implies A is missing. That's why this decomposition is not dependency preserving. Okay, so this is not satisfied because here D implies A is missing. That's why this decomposition is not correct. Okay. This is the information about dependency preserving. Thank you very much.